So the correct answer is the third one. So you might have been tempted to choose the first one here because it's the shortest, because you're trying to respect the fact that Debbie is on the go and she's busy and doesn't have a lot of time to engage with your application. But actually, she'll have to spend more time if you use a notification like this. She actually has to press the notification and go into the app to see what book is overdue and for how long. It actually doesn't really tell her anything. So in the end, this is actually a really bad choice. The second one might look tempting because it does give her some more information, but she still has to either launch a navigation app if she doesn't know where the library is, she might be really far away, or if she wants to extend the books, let's say that your application allows her to do that, she still has to go into the app, and that's not really respecting her limited time and her split attention with the real world. So the best one is the third option, because in one glanceable notification, she can completely engage with your application and not actually have to enter it. And she has these nice contextual actions where she can extend the book or navigate there with just one button press.
That was awesome. I did notice one thing. Debbie is holding her phone with a single hand.
Ah, yes, that brings us into our next mobile constraint, which is handedness.